गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू जूलॉजी ऑनलाइन क्लास। सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑन स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ इंटेगुमेंट इन फिशेस। स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ इंटेगुमेंट इन फिशेस। सो दिस इज द डायग्राम ऑफ स्किन ऑफ स्कॉलेडॉन, how it appears. Okay, skin occurs only in vertebrates. It's covering the entire surface of the animal body, and it can be easily separated from the underlying muscular layer of the body wall. So skin is made up of mainly two layers of cells, epidermis and dermis. This upper layer is epidermis, this one is dermis. Epidermis is stratified multi-layered, region. So this epidermis is derived from ectoderm of the embryo. Whereas dermis is derived from the mesoderm of the embryo. Okay, so this is scale. It is placoid scale. Now we shall discuss the structure of epidermis. So epidermis, it is a stratified epithelium. It has several layers of cells. The innermost layer, this is innermost layer. This innermost layer of the cells is having cuboidal cells. These are cuboidal cells, and this layer is called as stratum germinativum. So stratum germinativum undergoes mitotic division to produce similar type of cells. Uppermost layer of the fish epidermis is not having dead cells. These cells are not dead cells, they are living cells. They have nuclei. Can you see here? Nuclei. Okay, and this layer may be rubbed off because of the swimming of fish through the water. The cells may fall off and new cells are replaced. New cells are coming from the lower layers. Lower layer cells are coming from the stratum germinativum. So these cells multiply and move towards the upper surface. As upper cells are removed, they are occupying their place. Among the outermost epidermal layer, here and there, single cell, unicellular mucous gland cells are present. They secrete mucus, and they are also called as goblet cells. These goblet cells secrete mucus, and that mucus It is present on the surface of the entire surface of the body, and it reduces friction with the water when it is moving through the water. Friction occurs. That friction is reduced by the presence of mucus. Okay, and this is stratum germinativum. So there is no stratum corneum. Stratum corneum is absent in fish because it is aquatic. Stratum corneum is present only in terrestrial vertebrates. Stratum corneum is present at the outer surface, at the surface of the body, and it is having dead cells. But here dead cells are not there. Stratum corneum is absent. sometimes the cells are flattened because of the accumulation of keratin. So flattening and keratinization occurs. But it has no, fishes are not having stratum corneum. So this is about the epidermis. So epidermis is derived from ectoderm. Next, coming to dermis. Dermis, the stratum corneum, stratum germinatum of the epidermis is lying on basement membrane. This is basement membrane. Can you see here? This is basement membrane, blue line. Basement membrane. This basement membrane is produced by dermis. Dermis, this part. Okay. Comparatively, the dermis is thicker than epidermis. Epidermis. So scales are embedded in dermis. Just below the basement membrane, you can see the chromatophores, presence of chromatophores. Chromatophores are pigment granules are there. Chromatophores have pigment granules, and these pigment granules produce color. Color to the skin. They give color to the skin. Okay. So this is dermis. Upper dermis is, of course, dermis is having the, it is derived from mesoderm, and it has connective tissues with white or collagen fibers. White or collagen fibers are here. Okay. And the cells are also present here, and the cells are present. Okay. The fibers are arranged parallel to each other, parallel to the surface of the body. They are arranged like this, not vertical. They are parallel, parallel to each other. Interior means just below the epidermis, the dermis is not having compact collagen fibers. Therefore, this is known as stratum luxum. Stratum luxum. This part is called stratum luxum. And here in the lower part of the dermis, the collagen fibers are compactly arranged. They are compactly arranged. Therefore, this part of the dermis is called as stratum compactum. Stratum compactum. Okay. So this is stratum luxum, stratum compactum. Okay. So the dermis has collagen fibers, nerves, blood vessels are there, chromatophores are present, smooth muscles are also present. Okay. So pigment granules, what they do, they impart color, they impart color to the skin. Okay. Then blood capillaries, here and there you can see blood capillaries. So blood capillaries supply nutrients to the skin. Okay. It nourishes the skin. Okay. Then nerve fibers. Here and there nerve fibers are present. Nerve fibers. What they do? They give sensitive nature. They make it sensitive to external stimuli. The skin is sensitive to external stimuli. That is because of the presence of nerves present in dermis. Okay, this is about dermis. So here, this is what placoid scale. In scolodon, scolodon belongs to Condystis, elasmobranchs, cartilaginous fishes. These fishes have microscopic placoid scales. These are placoid scales. So placoid scale has two parts: basal part, this is called basal plate, then upper part. So this upper part is projecting outside the epidermis, okay, and this is made up of dentine. Hard part of the scale is called dentine. This dentine is again externally covered by one more hard, still more hard part called vitrodentine. Still harder part, vitrodentine. Okay, and the basal part, basal plate is embedded in the dermis, and the plate is connected to the dermis with the help of Sharpley's fibers. Sharpley's fibers. The scale has a cavity at the center. This is called pulp cavity. Pulp cavity, you can see here, cells, odontoblasts. These odontoblasts secret the dentine part. You can see the dentine canaliculi. So these cells are extended into the dentine canaliculi. Okay, and in this pulp, the nerves are there, blood capillaries, veins, arteries, all these are present in the blood, pulp of the pulp cavity of the scale. So this is about the placoid scale. Okay, so different scales you must have studied. These placoid scales are present in scolodon or the chondrosis, elasmobranchs. Whereas in case of bony fishes, other type of scales are present. In bony fishes also, the structure of the skin is same. There also epidermis is present, dermis is there. Epidermis is having a stratum germinativum. Outermost layer is not having dead cells. Here and there mucus glands are present, they secrete mucus. And below this, basement membrane is there. Below the basement membrane, chromatophores are there. Chromatophores have, melanocytes. They produce color. They give color to the skin. And this is dermis part. Here also, in bony fishes also, same type of dermis is there. Dermis is made up of collagen fibers. Fibers are arranged parallel to the surface of the skin. And here and there, blood capillaries are present, nerves are there, nerve endings are there. All structure what we have studied is same in bony fishes also, but the difference is their scales are different. In bony fishes, scales, placoid scales are present in elasmobranchs, whereas in teleos, means bony fishes, cycloid, tenoid and ganoid scales are present. Okay, so these scales are different in structure. Placoid scales present only in elasmobranchs. So elasmobranchs exist only in salt water, marine water, whereas teleos, they can occur in marine water as well as fresh water. Okay, so this is about the structure of integument or skin in fishes. So today's question, at the end of this topic I will give you a question. The question is, draw the diagram of vertical section of skin of scolodon. So what I gave you in the class, see, this is the structure. So draw this diagram and label it properly, neatly draw and send it to me. Okay, so in the next class I'll be dealing with the structure of integument in frogs. Okay, thank you.